Yeah, welcome to the CAD/CAM CAE lecture series. Today we are going to see the milling machine and one test program, and then what do we mean by the cutter compensations, both the diameter compensation for cutter and the length compensation for cutter. So basically cutter size compensation, so CNC has built-in cutter diameter compensation. See, when we say we have to do a milling operation and we have a part, and besides the part we need to do the side milling or contour milling, then the tool will be designated with its center. So if I instruct the tool to go to a particular XY location, the tool center will reach to that location. And since milling is a path operation, so what path is going to be followed by the tool, okay, that is first set up, and then that path is being followed by the center of the tool. So if I have to say do the side milling by 1 millimeter, okay, I have to remove 1 millimeter of material in terms of XY plane, okay, from the sides. So ideally I will be cutting the material from the sides, okay, 1 millimeter. So if I instruct the tool to reach to that particular location from where it is going to follow the contour path, then the tool center will reach to that location, and instead of removing 1 millimeter of material, the tool will directly remove the radius of material. So the material equivalent with the radius of tool. So to avoid that, okay, to avoid that, there are compensations. Okay, there are compensations. And earlier in the manual operation, these things are adjusted by the operator. But when we are talking about CNC and everything will be automated, then these things has to be precisely thought and then accurately put up into the system. And one such method is called as compensation. So what we do is we create an offset tool path, okay, offset tool path, and that offset distance should be greater than the radius of the tool. So let's say I have a contour path to be followed. So I will create an offset tool path which will be minimum greater than the radius of the tool, and after that the distance, the offset distance will depend on how much material we want to remove in single pass, and then there are many other options which we can work with. So the allowance is read by the control system, no need to calculate offset coordinates. So what we do is, okay, since everything is automated, we don't keep on calculating the offset paths, offset distances, and then create offset path. Okay, we just switch on these compensations. So if I switch on the diameter compensation, the offset tool path is automatically generated by the control system, and then tool follows that offset tool path to machine the workpiece. So program can be directly written based on component profile and two direction with control mode X and Y. So the XY control, okay, XY control, we call it as two directional control. So offset tool path, whenever we are working with offset tool paths, we are working with milling machine centers, we assume that the workpiece is situated in a top plane, okay, workpiece is situated in a top plane, and the top plane is basically XY plane. So that is why two direction motion, and the control is with both X and Y direction. So offset tool path, the tool is moving freely in the XY plane and it has a total control on its movement. Then while we are talking about the movement of tool in the XY plane, okay, then there is a question, okay, how the tool will come to know which plane is a base plane. So that is based on the G codes that we select, so preparatory G codes. So since CNC control works in 2D plane, that is need to be select appropriate plane. So we first have to select the appropriate plane. Normally when we are working with 3-axis vertical milling machine center, okay, we work in XY plane, and there are specific codes for XY plane, ZX plane and YZ plane. So as you can see over here, for XY plane, G17 is a port. Okay, so selection of XY plane, XY coordinates in same block. So when I have to give the tool motion, okay, when I have to give the tool motion, I have already used G17. That tells the controller that the motion of the tool is going to be in XY plane. Okay, motion of the tool is going to be in XY plane. So I can change XY coordinates. Okay, I can change XY coordinates in the same block. So let's say I am at location X0, Y0. Okay, and I have to reach to a location X30, Y30. Okay, X30, Y30. Then I can give this new coordinates. Okay, in the same block. So let's say I have started with G01. Okay, X00 was the first position. Then I gave G01. X30, Y30. Okay, X30, Y30. If I wrote this X30, Y30, the tool is going to follow a straight line path from X00, XY00 to XY30, 30. Okay, so, and since I have started the G01, that is linear interpolation, it will follow that particular line with a specific feed. Okay, with a specific feed. So that is what we will try to give. And also the z coordinate motion will be provided in the next block. Now I cannot write x30 y30, and let's say initially the tool was at x equal to 0, y equal to 0, 0 and z equal to 0, and then if I have to start the contour, okay, from x30 y30 z minus 10, then I cannot write all these three coordinates in the same block. That is not possible when I'm working with these G17, G18, G19 ports. Okay, because these are plane specific ports, and for that particular plane, the single coordinate can work in the same block. But if I have to work with the remaining third coordinate, then I have to write it in separate block. So let's say I will instruct the tool to go to X30, Y30, then I will ask the tool to go down to Z minus 10 in the next block. So that is why it is written over here, XY coordinates in same block, Z coordinate in next block. Similar is the case with G18, that is selection of ZX plane, in that ZX coordinates in the same block and Y coordinate in the next block. And similarly G19, that is selection of YZ plane, so YZ coordinates in the same block and X coordinate in the next block. So I hope this is understood. This is not that difficult to understand. Now let us come back to the cutter diameter compensation, the one which we were talking earlier. So now cutter diameter compensation has two specific codes. Okay, so let's say this is the material. Okay, this is the workpiece. Okay, and I have to follow the workpiece. Okay, this is the path of the milling cutter. Okay, path of the milling cutter from where it is going to start. So G41 is a left side. Okay, G41 is a left side compensation. So let's say this is explained in a more precise way over here. So this is a workpiece. This is my tool. This is the direction of motion. So this is a spindle rotation direction. Okay, this is a clockwise direction. And when I say G41, so it will create an offset tool path around the workpiece, and it will have the clockwise motion. Okay, clockwise motion for the tool. Okay, around the workpiece. So the tool is going to follow the workpiece from, by keeping itself on the left hand side, and it will have workpiece on the right hand side, and the direction will be a clockwise direction of contour following. Okay, clockwise direction of contour following. Remember, the tool is rotating in clockwise direction, and also the tool is rotating, or tool is moving around the workpiece in clockwise direction. So this is called as climb. Okay, this is called as climb motion. Okay, this is called as climb motion. So in that climb motion, I have clockwise rotation of spindle, and the tool is going to follow the workpiece in a clockwise direction. So both are clockwise in this case. Okay, the other is a G42. So as you can see over here, for G42 to take place, the tool direction will change. Okay, so tool direction will become counterclockwise. So as you can see in G42, it is a right direction cutter diameter compensation. And in that what happens is the tool is following the offset tool path by keeping itself on the right of the workpiece, and workpiece will stay on the left of the tool. So here again the direction of rotation of spindle is clockwise, but the direction in which the tool is going to follow the offset path around the workpiece is counterclockwise. So here this direction will be followed by the tool. So this is G42 and it is called as conventional. So you have spindle rotation clockwise and tool is going to follow the workpiece in a counterclockwise manner. Okay, in a counterclockwise manner. So that is called as conventional, and that is G42, and the prior one was G41, where it is the spindle rotation clockwise and tool is going to follow the workpiece through the offset tool path also in clockwise direction. So I hope this is understood. Okay, just to explain this concept in a more precise manner, we have G41, that is tool motion to the left of the program surface, G42 tool motion to the right of the program surface, and you have G40 that cancels the cutter diameter compensation. So just to give an example, as you can see we are using G41. Okay, G41. So outer surface clockwise, inner cavity counterclockwise. Okay, inner cavity counterclockwise. So see, it automatically happens. So let's say I have to follow this tool path. Okay, I have to follow this tool path which has an internal cavity. Okay, the first thing that is required is tool diameter to be less than the this particular gap, and by how much? If I divide this gap into two, the tool diameter should be less than the half of this length of the cavity. Okay, this, then only the tool is going to enter. So that those are few prerequisites. So let's say we start from the set point. Okay, we have to follow this particular cavity from the start point and come back to the start point again and trace the entire path. So what will happen, we come to this, since the tool stays on the left hand side, we will switch on G41. So G41 is switched on, and before that I have G01. Okay, G01. So G01 is switched on, and then G41 is going to ensure that the tool motion to the left of the program surface. So it is going to follow till here. Then I will change to G02. Again G41 will continue. Okay, G41 will continue. It will come here. Then again I will start with G01. G41 will still continue. Okay, as you can see, still the programmed surface is on the right hand side, and the tool is on the left of the program surface. So it comes here, then it goes inside. Okay, then it goes inside, and then still the tool is on the left of the program surface. Okay, tool is on the left of the program surface, and since we are going inside the inner cavity, as you can see, the direction of the tool motion, okay, direction of the tool motion through which it was going to trace the path of the workpiece got changed. So earlier it was clockwise. As it moved inside the cavity, that was the inner cavity, the direction became counterclockwise. Direction became counterclockwise, and this way it came out and again back to the set point. So everywhere I am following G41. Okay, everywhere I am following G41. Okay, so it says outer surface clockwise, okay, and inner cavity counterclockwise, and this is the G41 code. So if I am following the G41 code, okay, the directions will keep on changing, and that is the way we will get the tool path traced. Okay, then the next is G42. Let's say now I will have the tool motion in the counterclockwise, okay, around the workpiece, and let's say my tool is rotating in clockwise direction. So it, from set point, it is going to come here. Then since my G41 is on, my G01 is already on over here, since all my edges are straight lines. So G42, okay, it is going to trace this path. Now the scenario over here is the tool motion to the right of the program surface. So my tool stays on the right side and workpiece stays on the left side. Here what was happening, tool was on the left side, workpiece was on the right side. So my G42, it came out. Okay, then I will have to adjust my tool inside, and again I will have to make G42, 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 G42. Now the change, what will happen is, since I have to keep tool on the right hand side, workpiece on the left hand side, my direction will become clockwise in the inside cavity, and for the outside cavity or for the outside surface, my direction is going to be counterclockwise. So these are the two basic differences between the G41 core and G42 core. We use G40 to cancel both the cutter diameter compensations. Okay, to cancel both the cutter diameter compensations. Now the next thing is cutter length compensation. Okay, cutter length compensation. So this is also very important thing. So G43 is a code used for tool length compensation positive. So what happens with G43 is, with G43, a value from the offset register, okay, can be called up and added to the tool length. So with let's say H as the special character which is stored for storing the value, okay, that H register will have some predefined value stored in that, okay, and G43 will use that value and it will add that value to the tool length, and it will calculate the total tool length based on these circumstances. So with G43, a value from the offset register can be called up and added to the tool length. To all following Z movements with active XY plane, that is G17 is already on, and we are saying we are working with Z movement. So we are working in a XY plane, and Z is the direction which will be used to define the depth of the workpiece. Okay, remember we are working with the milling operations, okay, and milling machine centers. So by default we are working with G17 code, so which states that active plane is XY plane. So to all following Z movements in the program, this value will be added. So the example way of explaining this or using this in a program, I have sequence number G43 followed by H. So for example, sequence number G43 H01. Okay, that is the way I will be using this. So the value which is written into the register under H01 will be added to the following Z movements as tool length. Okay, so there will be some defined tool length. Okay, and if you want to have a length compensation included, I will be using G43 code, and before using G43, I will ensure that I have some value stored in the H register. Okay, H register, and I will have some value number or a value itself. Okay, H01 will be the value itself, or it will be the address where that value is stored in the register. Okay, it depends which controllers we are using. Okay, which controllers we are using. But this is the way the length compensation has to be inputted inside the program. Then the next one is, as we have G43, that is tool length compensation positive. The other is G44, which is tool length compensation negative. It is exactly works in a similar way, but since it says negative tool length compensation, so the value which is stored in the offset register will be subtracted from the tool length value, and then the new value will be implemented. So with a G44, value from the offset register can be called up and subtracted from tool length, and to all following Z movements with active XY plane, that is G17, in the program, this value will be subtracted from. Okay, so the example way of using it, N, that is any sequence number, then G44 followed by the H. It can be H01, H02, H03, and so on. What will happen? The tool length value will be recalculated based on whatever value is stored after H. Okay, either it would be the exact value or it would be the address of that particular value where it is stored. So that value will be called up, okay, it will be subtracted from the tool length value, and the new length will be applied, or new length will be implemented. And that was for G43 and G44, and to cancel the tool length compensations, we use G49. So the positive G43 or negative G44 shift will be cancelled, okay, shift will be cancelled. And how we use this as directly G49. So it is a normal safeguarding of the machine. Okay, so before we start a new program, okay, initial blocks we make sure that any prerequisite compensations or canned cycles, if they are already running on the machine, we cancel them. So before starting up the new program, we cancel all the compensations with the help of G49. We cancel tool length compensation. With G40 we cancel the cutter diameter compensation or tool diameter compensation, and G80 we cancel all the cant cycles. Okay, we cancel all the cant cycles. So we safeguard the machine so that it can work with the fresh program and with fresh settings. So this is the explanation. This was the explanation about the compensations, both the diameter compensations and length compensations on the cutter. Okay, let us move ahead and see a simple program. So this is a example geometry that we have in front of us. So milling cutter is going to be 10 millimeter flat end mill. Okay, this spindle speed is going to be 1200 rpm. okay, feed is going to be 400 millimeters per minute, and plate thickness is going to be 10 millimeters. So this is the geometry, 100 millimeter 60, then I have a radius of 25, then vertical downward, then a slanted line. Okay, and then back to the origin. Okay, back to the starting point. Okay, so this is the way it will look like, the simulation environment, and we'll quickly see how this works. Okay, how this works. So I'll quickly start the simulation over here. So as you can see, this is the way the simulation starts. Okay, it tries to remove the stock material from the sides. Okay, and slowly it approaches the part edges. Okay, and as it come near the part edges, the finishing is required. So what we do is while setting up the rough cycle and finish cycle, we give optimum values of step overs, so that as it comes near the edge, okay, this step over size is reduced and we get a good finish at the outset, okay, at the outer surface. So that is how the milling operation will be carried out. And as you can see, this is the entire finished part. Okay, this is the entire finished part. Although it will have certain edges. Okay, it will have certain edges. Yeah, it will have certain edges remaining, but that is okay. Okay, that is okay. And this is the manual part program. So as normally the program will start with a percent sign, then the number of the program, 0883. The milling cutter diameter 10, that is the tool number 1. Z 2 mm above the part surface. Okay, that is the initial position of the tool. The program will start. So N010, G00, rapid mode, G40, G80, G49. So this is what I was exactly talking about. Cancellation of the cutter diameter compensation, cancellation of the cant cycles, and cancellation of the tool length compensation. Then I have G71, that is metric programming, and G90 is the absolute mode of or absolute positioning system. Then I will carry out the tool change. So I will change the tool to N06 T01, where T01 is my flat end mill with diameter 10. Okay, flat end mill with diameter 10. Then I will reset or reposition the home position for the tool. So G92, resetting of the home position to X-40, Y-40, Z20. Okay, X-40, Y-40, Z20. Then in the next line, again in a rapid mode, I will take the tool to the bottom left corner. Okay, bottom left corner of my workpiece, and that is what we generally call it as the part origin. Okay, or workpiece origin. So X0, Y0, switch on the spindle in clockwise direction, and the speed will be 1200 rpm. Okay, 1200 rpm. Then in the next line, I am going to switch on the cutter diameter compensation. Okay, cutter diameter compensation to the left of the program surface. So G43 I am going to switch on. Z2H01. Okay, Z2H01. So H01 is going to be the value. Okay, value of the offset value to create the offset path. Okay, offset tool path, which will be used by G43 command. And I am going to switch on the flood type coolant. Okay, flood type coolant. Then again G00, Z-40. So I will lower the tool to Z-40, and F400, so feed is adjusted to 400 millimeters per minute. Okay, then G01, G17, okay, and G41. See, this G43 is the tool length compensation. It is not the diameter compensation. G43 is the tool length compensation, as we saw over here. Yeah, this is tool length compensation positive. Okay, so positive tool length compensation is switched on and the value is taken from this register, okay, H01. So that value is taken, and then in the next line, G01, G17, okay, to select the XY plane as the home plane, and then I am going to switch on the G41. Okay, G41. So G41 will ensure that the direction is going to be on from the left hand side. Okay, from the left hand side, the tool is going to be situated on the left hand side of the workpiece. The workpiece edge will be on the right hand side, just as we saw over here. Okay, so the motion was like this. So the clockwise motion of the workpiece of the tool around the workpiece. Okay, and the tool is also rotating in a clockwise manner. Okay, tool also rotating about itself in a clockwise manner. So that is what this G41 will ensure. So G41, and then I am giving the next coordinate, that is Y100. So this is point number 2. Okay, then X60, horizontally it will come to X60. Okay, then G02, I am going to change the linear interpolation to circular interpolation clockwise. Okay, because this is a clockwise path. Okay, so this is point 1, this is point 2. So from X0, Y0 to Y100, then X60, then G02, and it is going to follow this radius and come to X60, Y50. Okay, X60, Y50, this is going to be the end coordinate. And it is going to follow the radius 25. Okay, it is going to follow the radius 25, and it is going to follow the radius in a circular clockwise manner. So that is G02. Then from that point again back to linear interpolation, that is G01. It will come down to, let's say, Y30. Okay, it will come down to Y30. Yes. Then from there it is going to come to X30, Y0, as you can see. X30, Y0. I can give two coordinates, XY coordinates in the same line. Okay, two XY coordinates in the same line, that is possible. So it can follow the slanted line path. Okay, from here Y30 to X30, Y30. Okay, or X60, Y30 to X30, Y0. Okay, that is possible. It can follow that path. And from there back to the starting point X0. Okay, back to starting point X0, which is this point. Okay, which is this point. So X0. Okay, then I am going to switch off everything. So G40, G49, I am going to switch off the cutter diameter compensation. I am going to switch off the cutter length compensation. Then switch off the spindle and switch off the coolant supply. Then I will change the mode to G00, rapid mode. I will bring the tool up to Z20 first. Then I will bring the tool back to set point X-40, Y-40. And then I will end the program. Okay, then I will end the program. So I hope the concept of tool compensations, okay, in terms of its diameter and in terms of its length, okay, is understood. And we have seen a very simple program, okay, very simple program of the same. So I hope to see you next time with more such interesting content on computer aided manufacturing. Okay, till then, thank you very much.